morning students. Today we'll start with exercise 1D. Right? Last video we have learned about rounding up the numbers to the nearest 100. Okay? Exercise 1D, in that question number 1, which of these numbers cannot be rounded in real life situations? Put a tick next to those which you can and a cross next to those which you cannot. Right? Means wherever you can round up the number, you have to put a tick mark, and wherever you cannot round up the number, you have to put a cross over there. Let's see how. Number A, your shoe size. Okay. Now let me guess and tell. Suppose your shoe size is 5. Right? And if your father is buying for you, shoe means round up the number. Instead of 5, rounding up the number is 10. Nearest 10 is 10. Right? So if your parent is buying, if your father is buying for you shoes of number 10, is it comfortable for you? No. 10 number is not for you, right? You need 5 number shoes. So if you round up the shoe number and tell to someone to purchase, then that is not comfortable to you to wear it, right? So here in this case, you have to tell the exact number which you want, right? So shoe size cannot be round up, right? Now number B is your telephone number. Okay, if I tell my telephone number to you, rounding up, okay, then can you connect to me? No. If one single digit is also changed in our telephone number, we cannot connect to each other. That person will connect to someone else, right? You cannot connect to the person whom you want to talk. So your telephone number cannot be round up. You have to tell the exact telephone number to your friend or to your teacher or whatever, whomsoever you want to talk, right? So put a cross over there, that cannot be rounded up. Next is number of children in your city. Okay, if I ask you how many members are there in your house, some might be telling me answer, means you might be giving me answer like this, that we are 4 members in our house, we are 10 people in our house, means approximate whatever number you can tell exact number over there, right? If I ask you how many members are there in your society, you might be not knowing, but then you can tell approximate. Okay, in our society there are 15 houses. So, and if in my house 4 are there, it might be possible that everyone will have 4. It may be somewhere 3, somewhere 5. But if we count 4, and then if we multiply 4, 15 fours are, like that way you will tell me the exact approximate number of the members in your society, right? So you can round up that number, right? Same way, if we talk about city, how many number of children are present in your city, means in Anand city, how many children are there? Approximate, we can tell that this are the number, approximate this many children will be there in your city. So you can tell here rounding up figure, okay? So it is possible to tell the round up number, right? Next is your house number. Okay, if you are inviting your friend to your house, right, and then you are telling, giving the address, full address properly, right, but the house number you are telling by rounding up the figure. Now suppose your house number is 7, you are rounding up to 10 and telling my house number is 10, right? So what will happen? That the friend of your, what, he or she will go to the 10 number house instead of your house. Afterwards, by your name, they can recognize and they can search and find out your house. But if you round up the number, then obviously they'll go to the wrong house. So here also, in this case, you cannot round up the number. You have to tell exact number of your house. So put a cross over there. Again, number of books in a library. Okay, if you have a library at your home, and if I ask you how many number of books are there in your library, might be some of you may know exact number of the books, but might some of you don't know the exact number, but you know by looking that, okay, in one shelf I have 10 books, like that I have 15 shelves, so I might be having 150, but you don't know exact. So what you will say? Madam, approximate, it will be 150 or 160, right? So that you can tell like that I have this many books by rounding up the numbers, right? This is the way how you can round up in this case, right? Now let us move to question number 2. In question number 2, they are telling you here is 10. Now here it is 65. Remember that last time I told you that first you have to say what is a tens place. What is a tens place? Tens place 6 is given. Now move to the next digit and circle that digit and see that whether it is a strong number or weak number. It is 5. 5 is a strong number. That is having a power to push 6 to the next digit. And so 6 will be moving to 7. And instead of 5 you have to write 0. So 65 is rounded to 70. Same way 91. Just see what is a tens place. It is 9. Go to the next digit and then circle it to decide strong or weak number. 1 is a weak number, so it doesn't have any power to move the digit. So 9 will remain as it is. And instead of 1 you are writing 0. So 91 is rounded to 90. Right? Same way here 3 digit number is given, but you have to do tens. What is a tens place? Underline that. What is a tens place? Tens place 8 is given. Right? Tens place 8 is given. Now see what is the next digit. Next digit is 8. Circle it. See that whether it is strong or weak. It is strong number. So, stop. So, 8 is not a strong, 8 is not a weak number. It is a strong number. It has the power to push this 8 to the next digit. And that is why it will convert to 90. Right? So, what we'll do here, we'll write, instead of 8, we'll write here 9. Instead of this 8, we'll write 0. And this 4 will remain as it is. You have to ignore this 4 because we are looking for nearest 10. So, same 4 you have to copy down here. Once again, in 919, okay, once again, see here, we are going to do nearest tens. What is that tens place? It is 1, right? Go to the next digit, round that figure and tell whether it is a strong number or weak number. It is a strong number because it is 9. So, 9 has power to push 1, okay? So, instead of 1, you will write here 2 and instead of this 9, you will write here 0 and this 9 will remain as it is, right? Like this way, you have to round up the numbers to nearest 10. Let us move to the next question, that is round to nearest 100. Okay, now we have to see here which digit is at 100 place. Okay, here at 100 place it is 4. Go to the next digit, that is 3. Circle it. Strong or weak number? Decide strong or weak number. 3 is a weak number. 3 don't have power to push 4. So 4 will remain as it is. And instead of 36 we have to write 400. 00. So 436 is rounded to 400, right? Same way 651. Again underline 100 place it is 6. Move to the next digit 5. 5 is a strong number. It has a power to change 6. 6 will get converted to 7. And then 2 zeros we have to add instead of this. So 651 is rounded to 700, right? Same way here 205. Instead of what is a 100 place? 2. See the next digit. Next digit is 0. 0 is a weak number. It don't have power to push 2. So 2 will remain as it is. Instead of 0 and 5, 0, 0. So 205 is rounded to 200, right? Same way here. 100 place 5 is given. Go to the next number. Next digit, that is 3. Decide whether it is strong or weak. It is a weak number. It don't have power to push 5. So 5 will remain as it is and instead of 36 you will write 0, 0. So 536 will be round up to 500, right? Now let us move to next question, that is question number 4, okay? Question number 4 is word problem. Okay. I will explain you the word problem by reading first. Okay. Question number 4 is use the digits 8, 3, 6 to build a number that rounds up to 370. I repeat, use the digits 8, 3 and 6 to build a number that round up to 370. Okay. 370. Now see here. If I build this number by using this digit, if I build a number, what will I can build 836, 386, 683, then 638. So many are there. Right here. Let us see. First 836. then 863, right? Then 386, 386, okay? Then 638 and 683. One more is there, that is 368. These are the numbers which you can build by using this 3 digits. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right? 6 different numbers you can build by using this digit. Now from this, which is our number which can round it up to 370? Now see here, it is 3 first. So our first digit also will be 3, not 8, not 6. So this will be cross, 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 cross. Now we have these two numbers. 386. And 368. Let us try to round up this number. Okay. 386. 3. After 3, that is 8. 8 is a strong number. It will push 3 and change the number to 4. So it will be 400. So this number is not possible. Right. Now after 3, this is 6. 6. Right. 368. Now 368. 6 also have power to push this. Right. And it will push and make it to 400, right? So this is also not possible, right? So now what we can do? See, we have just now think only over the number, that is to rounding up this number to nearest 100, it is possible. This thing can happen. But if we round up this two numbers to nearest tens, let us see what happens. Okay, 386, tens is 8, then 6. 6 is strong number, it has a power to push this, it will become 390, right? 3 will remain as it is. Same way, 368, 6, 8, 8 is a strong number, it has power to push this, so 3 will remain as it is. Instead of 6, you will write 7 and then 0, right? So our number is 368. Okay, you have built the number by using this 3 digit which can round up to 370. Is that clear everyone? This is the matter of it, right? That's all for today.